3, 2. All right, hi everybody. This is mxux, and this is a presentation on why I think Workhorse is underrated. And I don't think it's the post office deal, although I do think this is going to be the new postal van, and I think they're going to build it at Lordstown Motors. That's the smaller Workhorse van they have. Let me just go through these slides here. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Ooh, look at that. So here's one of Amazon's drones. They got many different prototypes out. They spent $100 million, $1 billion on research. Anyway, give you an idea of the cost savings here. Right now, to deliver a package, it's $1 a mile. That's the cost to deliver packages, I guess. It's $1 a mile for a conventional truck, internal combustion truck, like a UPS truck that you have now. If you move to an electric truck, like the Workhorse C1000, it cuts that by 66%. It takes the cost down, and that's just changing to electric, to 34 cents a mile from $1. Then, if you go by drone, it takes it down from 34 cents to 4 cents a mile. And I think that's supposed to be a 96% saving. So, the amount that can be saved by implementing drones in delivery for e-commerce, and we know that, you know, this e-commerce trend that's going on is going to stick after everything's over that we're going through right now. So, delivery costs and getting delivery costs down is a big deal. That's why Amazon is so obsessed with it. And, you know, just they did buy or they did partner with Rivian to build the vans. They got those little plastic vans they're building. I'm not sure how that's going to go. Let's move on to the next slide here. This is a video of their very first drone delivery. They got a pilot program that's been working in England, at a small, I forget what the village is, West Ham or something. I don't know where it is, but anyway, there's a warehouse relatively near the village, and they gave them the licenses to run the drone, so they're doing the drone deliveries there. That's their first drone delivery there, and that's kind of their pilot program, was overseas in the UK. And, you know, they fly out from the warehouse and they go and they drop it off. And, you know, it's a pilot program. It's been working for them. Anyway, here it is again. All right. Let that play. Anyway. Now, here's one of their drones. They have, I don't know. The new one looks like a TIE fighter. I think this is one of the first iterations they had. But, you know, like I said, the new ones are completely different from this. I think they have a lighter payload. But one of them kind of looks like an old B-52. One of them looks like a TIE fighter. And then this looks like, I don't know, it looks like they got a little Bondo on there. I don't know what they're doing with that thing. Anyway. Here's their drone program. They started it in 2013, and they expect to save, by implementing drones, $43 billion on deliveries. $43 billion. I don't know what that, what is that, you know, the income of Western Europe. gross domestic product. Anyway, they spent $100 billion. That's not an incorrect figure, I checked it. $100 billion on research and development. And they spent $9.4 million just in lobbying fees to they had to lobby to get FAA approval to operate in the United States. And I don't know what that was all about, but anyway, they had to you know, spread a little money around to expedite disapproval, because it test, I guess it takes a while. And anyway, they pushed it. So they got a pilot program in England, and it's doing deliveries from one warehouse, and it's, you know, a very simple program. And as I said, the drones are stationed at a delivery center, a warehouse outside of town. And in all of these situations that Amazon is facing, it's the range limits of the drone that's the problem, and it means that the warehouse they're based in has to be close, quotes, to the customers. And I think the range, I'm not sure on their drone that they're coming up with, and I'm sure there's a weight to payload curve, and I don't know, you guys, you math heads can figure that out. Go for it, eggheads. Anyway, the drone range limits, let's say it's 15 miles. Let's say it's 15 miles round trip, or 15 miles one way, whatever. The warehouse has to be close to the customers. If it's any further than that, they can't, either they can't carry any weight, or the drone can't make it back. So they have a problem, and all these land-based drone schemes have the same problem of range. And you know, I guess it's the control signals that go to the drone and everything else. Anyway, it limits, it requires that they be stationed within a certain radius of the customers, so they can't get around it. Now, Amazon, you know, with their $100 billion, you know, these are the smartest guys in the room, right? They came up with a couple ideas here how to get around this range problem. Now, I call this the beehive. See this? This is a... Wait a minute. I went ahead. Okay, there we go. So this is a beehive. These are all little landing pads for the drones, all right? And they got hundreds of drones in here, and they got the trucks coming in, and then the workers coming in, and they pack the drones up, and they fly out, and then they fly back, and there's hundreds of drones flying in and out of this thing, right? And then this is another same thing, different shape, okay? Cookie jar. You got your trucks pulling in, your workers coming in, you got all your little drone holes coming out of here. It's like it's like the flying monkeys in the Wizard of Oz or something. I don't know. They're buzzing in and out and buzzing in and out and all this stuff. Anyway, again, this is how they're thinking they're going to do their land-based drones. Now, here's the thing. In this scheme and this former scheme, the beehive and the cookie jar, here's the rub. They want to put these things close to the customers. That means in the middle of urban areas, you know, inside of town, you know, down the block, you know, at the empty field next to the middle school. So these things ain't going to be out, you know, out in the middle of the country, because that's where their warehouses are now. These have to be closer by definition. Like, they're talking about having them right in the middle of New York City and Chicago. And anyway, okay, so we're going to have this thing. We're going to have one of these. It's going to be in Los Angeles, and, you know, it's going to be right in the middle of Culver City or wherever, and you're going to have all these things flying overhead in and out all day long. And anyway, this is their other idea they came up with, is a blimp. This is some Japanese artist came up with this, but they're talking about, and they got drawings on this. I don't know if they filed a patent on this or not, but anyway, you get the blimp. It's the blimp warehouse. Okay? It's the Zeppelin approach, Led Zeppelin approach. So they got a blimp. So in this case, they get around having to make these multiple closely stationed warehouses with all the little drone holes in them, you know, with the flying monkeys coming in and out. He got the blimp. He got this giant blimp, and this blimp is just going to go over in the neighborhood and wherever they're needed, and they're going to hover there. I don't know how high. It's not going to be this close, but, you know, how high could it be, right? Because there's planes and stuff. So anyway, it's going to be up there, and it's going to have all these drones. There's going to be people in there loading drones or robots or whatever, and this thing is going to fly over your neighborhood and stop, and, you know, a couple hundred of these things are going to come buzzing out of there and flying around the neighborhood. Anyway, this is a thing. I ain't making this up. So let's talk about Workhorse. Okay, that was Amazon. Now this is Workhorse. Now this is the same company that is up to do the USPS bid. Everybody's having a conniption about because it hasn't been let yet and so on. Let's just talk about their drone program and how they got started. Anyway, this is 2017, and this premiered at the Paris Air Show. And I mentioned this in my other videos, and some big wonk analyst was just on MSNBC talking about, well, you know, the next thing Uber's going to come up with is a flying drone taxi. And, you know, this, Steve Burns, the CEO, who's now CEO of Lordstown Motors, this was his pet project. And there's presentations on the web, on YouTube, you can check them out. But one of the cool things about this, forever practical, the arms bend down. And you can park it in your garage or in your driveway, you know what I mean, and park your car next to it. Anyway, this is all composite. It's kind of a hybrid. It's got batteries, and it's also got a small gasoline engine in it, two-cylinder engine. It's also got one of those ballistic parachutes that will fly out of the top right here, I guess. If everything fails, the parachute opens up and it lands softly. But anyway, there's double motors, okay? And so if one of the motors fails, the other one will work. And they got the ballistic parachute. And then they got the gas engine, which generates the power to run, you know, it's got two generators hooked up to it to run the propellers. And there's also, if that quits working, there's a battery. And when it's parked or whatever, it's like a Prius, you know, or whatever, the gas engine will charge the batteries. But this is all composite, and they called it a personal helicopter. This was back in 3 or 4 years ago when people weren't thinking like this. Anyway, the cool thing about this is it's autonomous. And well, the plans were, I mean, this is, I think this actually was a testing model here. I think they got it to that stage. But anyway, this was planned on being autonomous. And it has a display in it, you know, a flat panel display. And a map comes up and you just push a button where you want to go and it takes you there. And I think the top speed on it is 75 miles an hour. And there's some small manual controls you can override to fly it. But the point is, it's meant to be autonomous. And they're going to sell this for $200,000. And anyway, what happened was Steve Burns made a deal with a company called Moog. And he sold this off to them. And they agreed to go into a joint venture with Workhorse to get a field trial together, a prototype testing, so on and so forth, for their Workhorse drone, which I'll go into next. But what ended up with this is Moog bought this. There's some kind of conglomerate. It's in another video I have. Anyway, as I understand it, this is going to be, they bought it for a military application, and their thought or their proposal is to use it to supply frontline combat troops in an autonomous mode. So carry medical supplies, ammunition, food, whatever. And, you know, no pilots at risk, and it's autonomous. And anyway, that's the beginning of the drone program. They had another parallel drone program, which is this horsefly program. And they've been working on this, I think, since 2012. And here's the thing. The C-1000 is the truck. I don't think this is a C-1000. I think this is a regular UPS truck. Oh, it's a hybrid. Okay. So it's not a C-1000. I think we all know what the C-1000 looks like by now. Integrated with the C-1000 electric delivery vehicle. A truck is a jumping off point for the drone. And then after the drone makes the delivery, they meet up, and the drone lands on the truck. And phone call, text message, sorry. And the truck features a control center for the driver and auto landing horsefly roof with charging capabilities. So anyway, I'll show you a video on this in a second. Anyway, this is integrated fully into the truck. The truck battery charges the drone. The drone launches up and takes off. And then whoever's getting the delivery, they got a phone app, okay? And I don't know if you set this, well, anyway, there's a phone app, you get a text message or whatever, you go to a link, and you get a view on your phone from the camera that's in the drone. And then it's telling you where it's going and everything, and when it gets over your house, you know, you get your finger and you say, I want you to put the package here in the backyard. And you can watch the drone on your phone, and it flies over that spot. And then when it gets over that spot in your backyard, it stays like 20 feet off the ground. It lowers down a winch cord and drops the package up, goes up, and takes off. Pretty cool, huh? I know I could use this at my building, because I'll tell you what, every time the packages are left outside, the porch pirates steal everything. I've got like six packages stolen. I would just, I would love to get a text and say, where do you want the package? And I position it right into the courtyard and have this thing hover over the courtyard here and drop the package in. It would be great. No more stolen packages. And I'd like make that the default, so it would do it every time. I mean, I think this is a great system. Anyway, it's not limited. The only thing that limits it, they said, is really high electrical wires, like them big towers. They have those metal towers that go up. They look like the Eiffel Tower, you know, those type of transmission wires. And they said really, really big trees, which I don't know what that means, but there aren't many restraints on it. Here is a video of the thing in action. Okay, so the girl's driving the UPS truck. She stops. Ah, there's the package. All right, she puts it in the drone. She enters the destination address. The top opens up. I'm sure you've all seen this, right? And the drone goes up, and the drone takes off with the package. And the drone's flying, and the roof closed, and this chick's gone. She's making her next delivery. Meanwhile, the drone's just out flying around on its own, autonomously, doing a delivery. Now, she's doing another delivery. There's the drone. Oh, the drone found the spot. And this is an early version. They've made improvements on this. But anyway, the point is, the drone found the spot, right? Delivered the package. Now, there's the drone. No package. It's flying autonomously again. Meanwhile, she's been doing deliveries. She stops the truck to do another delivery, right? There's the drone. Drone comes back automatically, plops on the roof, parks again, there you go, gets covered up, gets the battery topped off, they go on to the next delivery. She can do this all day. So, you know, it can double or triple the work of one person, cut delivery costs. And the thing is, it's mobile, and it's on the van. And, you know, who knows, maybe they could put two of these things on a van or three of these things and, you know, boom, have them take off and have a guy, you know. I mean, I think it's a great system. And it's kooky. And when it first came out, it's kooky. And when I first saw it, I said, what is this? This is nuts. All these things, roofs opening up. It's like the Dr. No or something, right? But anyway, actually, they got it all worked out. They've been working on it for years. They're doing the medical deliveries in this joint venture with this MOOG subsidiary in South Carolina. And they're just on the edge of FAA approval. It's all FAA compliant. So, I mean, this is going to happen. Anyway, here's the drone, what it looks like. Again, I don't know how old this picture is. There's different versions of it. But anyway, it's mounted on top of their C-1000 delivery van. Okay, that's how they got the system worked out. Yeah, it's autonomous. It's all FAA compliant. They had to do all this safety stuff. If it fails, it breaks apart and all this stuff. Anyway, it's got a 45 mile per hour top speed. It's quiet, and again, there's all these redundant safety things built into it. You can look them up. Anyway, you know, the propeller, blah, 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 whatever. Anyway, and it can operate in a 25 mile per hour wind or rain or snow. No problem. And the cool thing is it has a winch that lowers the parcel 20 feet. So it kind of stays out of earshot. Even though the customers it's serving, it stays up there and it lowers the package and it takes off. So it's cool. It's quiet too. It doesn't come down to the ground and set down and, you know, have the whirling, you know, meat cutters flying and everything, you know, stay back, Johnny, stay back from the propellers, you know, that kind of thing. Anyway, so it's got a winch that drops the thing down, so you never have to get close to the thing, and it's quiet. And like I said, the driver sets the delivery. I don't know, you know, I'm sure they could just, you know, flash a QR code printed on the package to the drone, or I'm sure they got it set up some slick way of they just throw the box in the thing and it takes off. And again, the customer, you know, I'm sure they say your package, you know, you get a text, your package is coming today between 4 and 5. Watch for a text. Whoa, here's a text. The truck's at your block, blah, blah, blah. And then they say, the drone's taking off, and click this link, and then you go. And, you know, there's a camera looking down at the bottom of the drone, which is feeding video to your phone app, and then it gets over your location, and you just put your finger down and make a dot where you want it to drop the package, and it maneuvers itself into that position at the right altitude, lowers the package down. There you go. Bob's your uncle. I think it's pretty cool. Then it flies back to the truck, even if the truck's off making another delivery. So I would like to get packages like this, especially with the Rona going on. No contact deliveries. It's great. Plus, like I say, stay behind the security system here. Wonderful. I think it's a great system. Now, just a couple words about this C-1000 van. Steve Burns was head of the company when they came up with this, but this is a hub wheel motor. It's 100% composite body and frame. Eliminates 4,000 pounds of chassis and body weight compared to an ICE vehicle. Carries the same cargo volume and payload, being 4,000 pounds lighter. This weight advantage with its ultra low floor, and I read a quote from a driver in a Reddit, and you know, this is one of the reasons I got into this security. There was this driver, and he goes, he was like a UPS driver or something, and he said in this Reddit, he goes, I bought this stock at a dollar, you know, I bought, you know, I don't know how much he bought, but anyway, the point is, he goes, I drove one of these in a test or something. Anyway, he said, it's the nicest delivery van. It's the most driver-friendly delivery van that they have. And he was talking about the turning radius and the performance and all this. But the main thing he said was this ultra-low floor. It's a small step. It's like 7 inches off the ground. And that's what you get when you have these hub motors. And the driver said, with the other vans, you're constantly climbing up and jumping down and climbing up and jumping down. And you see all those guys are wearing back belts and everything. I mean, can you imagine doing that a couple hundred times a day? You know, jumping down 2 feet, climbing up 2 feet. This is 7 inches. It's like a normal step. Anyway, the guy said he loved it so much, that's why he bought this. Anyway, the ergonomic and cost-saving benefits. Alternative to traditional V's, more appealing. So anyway, between the ergonomics, and we went through the cost savings, just using an EV cuts the delivery cost from $1 to $34. And then you throw a van on top of this thing, and it cuts the cost to 4 cents. And then you got the lower floor, right? So the driver's going to be happier. There's going to be less injuries, and they're going to work better workflow, and they're going to have a drone doing half their deliveries. I mean, this is going to be such a productivity booster. I mean, anyway, and again, down here, composite body, 1,000 cubic feet. I don't know if I have another video, you can look at it. I think it's 10 things you need to know about Bob Burns. I'll put a link in the thing where a guy shows us how big this truck is. And anyway, and the C650 version, which is the 650 cubic feet, which I believe is that red one at the beginning, it's going to be the postal vehicle. I don't know that, but anyway, the range will be 100 miles. That's what these guys travel, 100 miles. So anyway, that's just about the Workhorse C1000 van. Now let's get back to this Amazon drone delivery. So anyway, oh, wait a minute. There's the Workhorse. This is an older version. This is not the new one, but it just shows you the way this is set up with the drone and everything. So, wait a minute. All right. So anyway, this is what they're doing. Let me try a different. I'm sorry. I'm trying a new system here. All right. So why would Amazon, with this truck-based zone drone? It's the obvious solution, right? It's the best. What does Elon say? First principles. I don't even know what that means. First principles: don't get arrested, don't get any pregnant, don't even get pregnant, don't get hurt. That's my first principles. Anyway, so why would Amazon do this? Would you want this thing flying around your neighborhood with the Wizard of Oz monkeys flying around there? Even worse, would you want this within 10 blocks of your house, constantly seeing these drones flying in and out of here 24 hours a day, flying back and forth, and trucks coming in? I mean, they want to put these within 15 miles or whatever of the customers. I mean, they're going to put them right in the middle of the middle of the towns and everything. I mean, a blimp, the flying monkey haven. I don't know what they're thinking. I mean, I don't know. They're smart, right? What do I know? Anyway, I think they got patents on both of these. So why would they do this, though? I mean, it seems so obvious to me what the solution is the truck-based drone. So why would they do this? Because Workhorse has a patent. They got a patent April 7, 2018, on their drone, truck-based drone delivery. They got a patent on the idea. Right here. Workhorse officials announced the United States Patent Office issued a patent number 9 billion for the Horsefly truck launch drone package delivery system. And UAV package delivery integrated with electric delivery trucks. So this, everybody's talking about the postal order, which is massive. But even without the postal order, with this C1000, with the way this truck's designed and the ergonomics and the way the whole thing works, and then integrating this drone into it and having it patented, I think this, even more than the postal regulation, postal market is why the stock's undervalued. Because, you know, what did Amazon say? They're saying it's going to be $43 billion. What a market. Anyway, that's my take. Anyway, I'm not a financial advisor. Good luck in the market. Thanks for watching the video.
Frank, it's the big shit. It's the blimp, Frank. It's the blimp. Blimp, you folks down the gutter, I'll give you a bottle of wine.